Hello and welcome to the end plate feature detail. The feature detail is a supplement to the manual that every user of SolidSteel parametric for Autodesk Inventor has available as a PDF. The manual describes everything in more detail, but it is recommended to follow the video step by step while doing it yourself in the software. For those who don't know, you can also try it all out with the free express version. If you haven't already, please go straight to our website to get your version of SolidSteel parametric. Okay. In general, we can create several types of end plates. We'll see which ones in a moment. End plates can connect profiles to any surface of other components. And of course, there are single and double end plates. Let's start with the simplest one, the single end plate. We will use the end plate tool, which will open the corresponding dialog. Now we select a source profile and then the face to which the profile is to be attached. We get a preview and can now define the end plate. Here we can set the thickness. I'll choose 20 millimeters for now. Then we need offsets so that there is enough room to weld the end plate to the beam. Minus 5 millimeters at the top and bottom should be fine. We could also rotate the end plate. Of course, this is only necessary in very special cases, just shown here so you know it is possible. Now we take care of the holes. To do this, we first define the corresponding bolted connection, which we start here below by clicking on Assemble. Here in the part selection, we define the complete connection and start with the desired screw. SolidSteel Parametric includes an international screw library that leaves nothing to be desired. A click on default mountings adds two washers and the matching nut. However, we could have manually selected the washers and the nut here. Confirm and the bolting is added. This still looks strange, so let's move on to defining the holes. We will need two rows, which we can define more precisely here. The upper value specifies the distance to the body edge of the end plate, and the lower value specifies the distance between the rows. Here, on the right side of the input, the value defines the column spacing, always symmetrical to the center of the end plate. This looks good, but there is one more important setting to do. We check the box at propagate holes so that the holes are also transferred to the column. If this box is unchecked, no holes will be added to the target profile. Once the end plate is defined, we can save our work as our own preset. Just enter a name at the top and confirm with save. At the moment, only the default template is available, but you can also create end plate templates with rounded corners or drain holes, for example. We could also change the material of the end plate down here. I confirm the end plate by clicking on execute, or here on the green plus, and the end plate is created. We can see here in the feature tree that a welded assembly has also been created automatically. And of course, the bolted joints have also been placed. Here on the opposite side, we have the same installation situation. We select the beam and face again, and immediately get a preview with an end plate identical to the last one. We have saved the end plate we just defined as a preset, but even if we don't, we can still work in series, because SolidSteel always remembers the last settings. This is very convenient and applies to all SolidSteel functions, not just end plates. Of course, this one is also added to the welded assembly. In step 2, we now come to the double end plate. The installation situation differs from the previous one in that the column is rotated by 90 degrees, and therefore we connect the beam with the end plate to the narrow surfaces of the flange. The work steps are the same as before. We select the source profile and then the flange surfaces and immediately get the preview of the last end plate because SolidSteel has memorized the entries. Of course, the bolted connection would not make sense with a single end plate, so we activate the double end plate option up here. The preview adjusts accordingly, and we can also see that the clamping lengths of the bolts have also been automatically adjusted. Furthermore, we can see that another menu item, plates are identical, has been added. We'll take a look at this menu item in a moment. Confirm and the end plate is added. As just mentioned, the plates are not always identical, which brings us to step 3. Let's take a look at this constellation where a lower stage beam is connected to a higher beam. We start as usual by selecting the source profile and the connection face. SolidSteel again selects the last entries, which of course make no sense here. We choose a standard end plate as a starting point. A large library of end plates is already included in SolidSteel. This is a European standard end plate, for example. Of course, we also want to have a double end plate here. Instead of enlarging both plates to the correct height, we uncheck the plates are identical option. This adds another input mask, second plate, to the dialog in which we can now change parameters. For example, I increased the bottom offset to 100 millimeters. That's too much, of course, so I tried to find the right offset. 80 millimeters is still too much. 70 millimeters is fine. The bolts also fit, since they are predefined in the standard end plates, we can confirm. Again, SolidSteel remembers the entries to create several end plates in a row, or we could save our own preset for this. This brings us to step 4 of this tutorial, the non-bending resistant end plate connection. Here we have a special case, an end plate connection on a beam with a coping. But of course this is also possible. We uncheck the double end plate option, then select the profile as usual and then this face on the web of the beam. The preview appears. I have already saved a preset for this spot, which I select up here. While editing, you will notice that the coping is hidden. Don't worry. As soon as the end plate is confirmed, which I will do now, the result is exactly what we expect. Previously, all connections were rectangular, which will change in step 5. Of course, we can also use SolidSteel parametric to install end plates in non-rectangular situations. For the user, everything is the same as usual. First, the source profile is selected and then the connection face. I select a standard end plate. And we see that the end plate has been automatically extended because the diagonally cut profile has a larger cut face. Of course, we should move the screws down a bit here to leave enough clearance for mounting. Then we activate the propagate holes option and confirm. Our non-rectangular end plate connection, including the bolting, is now complete. Okay, now that we know how to add new end plates, we will modify existing end plates in step 6. To edit existing end plate connections, we use the same tool but switch to the Change tab at the top and then select the plate. We see that SolidSteel now returns to the normal preview and we can now select, for example, a different standard plate. Of course, it has to be a double end plate here. Clicking on Execute completes the change and the new end plate is created. Of course, we can also remove the end plates, which we will do in step 7. To do this, we select the Delete Connection tool, which opens the corresponding dialog. We can simply select any component of the connection, for example the profile. The dialog then shows us the connections that exist on the selected component. We select the desired connection and click on Execute. The connection is now completely deleted and we can see in the feature tree that the welded assembly has also been removed. That's it, so much for end plates with SolidSteel parametric for Autodesk Inventor for today. Don't forget to like and subscribe and check out our website for more information.